Hi, this is Achmir with the Bulletin Board Heroes, a farmer special going into the Maybank holiday weekend. Another holiday after, what is it, 8 weeks of holiday effectively in the form of a lockdown. But starting off with a biotech stock, AOTech International, just because the chart here looks so good. Resistance line broken there at 90 pence at the end of last week and pushing higher ever since. Target here as high as the top of a rising December price channel at 200 pence. While we remain above 90 pence, that purple for 20-day moving average 81 pence should be the trading stop, hopefully, over forthcoming days and weeks. One of the best performers of the last week has been Avacta, which really cheered up the bulls. Just went shy of the previous target the last time we looked at the stock at £2, but at 198 so far. The high, could see the shares stretch up to that April resistance line projection of 230 pence. Over the next week or two, especially while we hold above recent, well, the support area of the last 24 hours, which is 160 to 170 pence. Another target hit here in terms of E Therapeutics, just at the 20 pence level, the top of that rising trend channel drawn last time from January. Looking for an end of day close or a weekly close above 20 pence to give the shares the next implied target as high as 30 pence. At the top of a rising trend channel, also from the beginning of the year. Stop loss on the buy argument currently just back below that gap around the 15.5 pence area, which we had at the end of last week. Going on to a stock which was one of the true heroes of the farm area until it had a placing and sort of knocked the wind out of the sails of the bull move. But we're looking now for any dips towards the 20-day line at 152 to be bought into, and stop loss back below, just below recent support at £1.43. If you want to buy trigger, probably end of day close above the neckline resistance, mid-May resistance at 179 would be the trigger for a move to partially or even fully retest that May spike that we had before. On to Novacyt, and here you can see that. Stock is still in consolidation mode, probably likely to hit the 50-day moving average area over the course of the next few sessions. Stop loss obviously back below that mid-April £2.73 level. So any dip towards or just below £3 likely as a decent technical entry point. And for after that, at least back to the £4 area, which was mid-May resistance. But only a weekly close really above £4 would take us up to having a chance of retesting or testing rather that resistance line from February, heading up to the big target here on Novacyt towards £7, hopefully over the course of the summer. Stock and holding and a holding pattern at the moment is a Mega Diagnostics, although the way it's going with these green candles and the sharply rising 20-day moving average, one would have thought there'll be a breakout relatively soon. A breakout meaning an end-of-day close above 55 pence to take the shares up to the top of this rising April trend channel at 80 pence. Stop loss at this stage back below 45 pence, but ideally there's no end-of-day close back below even 50 pence now. Another placing out the way and another stock here in terms of Open Orphan. Interesting that we've got green candles even on today, so that shows how bullish this situation has been and arguably still is. Uptrend line there from April, running at the 12 pence level, and hopefully that will allow, while we're above that, allow a move, let's say, towards 16, 17 pence initially. Big target here for the summer, up towards the top of that rising trend channel from last summer, heading towards 23 pence. So that's probably valid once we've cleared the 15 pence area on an end of day or end of week close basis. New stock for this space coming in the form of Renalytix. Here we've got a gap higher for the stock, a very technically significant looking move here. And the view is that while we hold above that gap and the £4 area could see a move towards £6.50, especially as we're in the run-up to a likely golden cross between the 50 and 200-day moving averages, currently near the upper 200 pence area. typically the strongest part of the cycle is the immediate run-up to a golden cross between those two averages. So we'll see how that particular situation pans out. On to Synergen, and a bit disappointing that we've had to consolidate for so long. Rather reminiscent of other charts that we've seen, like maybe Omega as well, that sort of a consolidation near support, which has gone on, felt like it's gone on and on forever. But end of day close above the 20-day moving average of 57 pence should be the trigger for a fresh move to the upside, and only well below, I suppose, 48, 49 pence, really delaying the upside scenario from now on. You'd also like to see the RSI back above neutral 50. It's 48 at the moment, so probably the safest way forward here is to wait for a break of the 20-day moving average. Finishing off with the stock of the day, arguably, for Friday anyway, with the big announcement from Tiziana regarding its spin-off. A solid candle there for the end of the week as well, and after that test of the old resistance line and new support, so the old resistance line from March yesterday. Still looking for that top of March trend channel target towards £1.20, perhaps even £1.25 over the next week or two, and really back below 80 pence, even beginning to delay the upside scenario. Ideally, there's a decent weekly close above that 90 pence double top that we had in April. Let's see how that particular situation goes. That's it for me today. More updates next week.